Ah, welcome back, fellow scientists. You're just in time to help me with my latest project. So, since we've been learning about how helpful simple machines are, I thought I would pay tribute to them by using each one of them to build the greatest structure known to mankind. A treehouse. I've already got the lever and the wheel and axle covered with my wheelbarrow. I'm going to use that to transport my supplies. Then I'm going to use a pulley to lift those supplies up into the tree. As for the rest of the simple machines, well, I think it's time we learned how they help us to do work. By the end of today's lesson, you will be able to identify inclined planes, wedges, and screws, and explain how they're related to each other. You will also be able to describe how each one helps us do work. Let's get into it. The first simple machine that I still need to include in my treehouse project is an inclined plane. Now, I'm not talking about an airplane up in the sky. A plane is just a flat surface. Inclined means something is raised at one end. So, an inclined plane is a flat surface that is raised at one end. You might know it by a different name, a ramp. Inclined planes help us move objects between high and low places. For example, if you've ever moved, you might know how difficult it can be to lift a heavy box straight up into the back of a moving truck. It would be much easier to push that box up an inclined plane into the truck. Inclined planes make work easier by spreading the force we need out over a longer distance. So instead of just picking the box up and lifting it straight into the truck, which is a large amount of effort over a very short distance, the inclined plane spreads that effort out over the length of the ramp, meaning that we can exert less force as we gradually push that box into the truck. This is probably why it feels easier to go up an accessibility ramp rather than a steep flight of stairs, or why hiking trails usually wrap around the side of a mountain instead of just going straight up it. By extending the distance, the force we need to do the work is spread out. As one of the simplest of the simple machines, inclined planes are everywhere. Curb ramps on sidewalks, book chutes at your local library, even slides on a playground. Actually, that's a great way to put an inclined plane in my treehouse. I'll put in a slide so it's much easier to get to the ground than climbing down the ladder. Fantastic! Where are other examples of inclined planes that you've seen? Pause the video here to jot down your thoughts in your guided notes. So now that we've got the inclined plane down, it's time to move on to our next simple machine, the wedge. No, you're not seeing things. The wedge is very similar to an inclined plane. It's kind of just two inclined planes glued together with a thick end and a thin end. The difference is how they're used. Wedges are used to break objects apart, like wood. Force is applied to the thick end of the wedge, which pushes the thin end into the wood. The wedge redirects the force applied, sending it outward. This, in turn, pushes the wood up against the wedge's inclined planes, breaking it apart. Wedges make breaking things into smaller pieces much easier. An axe, used for chopping wood, is a classic example of a wedge. But wood is certainly not the only material we might want to break into smaller pieces. A kitchen knife, for example, is a very thin wedge, and it cuts food apart in the same way an axe cuts wood. Your front teeth
actually work the same way. Pay attention to how they split food apart the next time you bite into an apple. Even the tines of a fork, when you look very closely, are wedges, making it easier to pierce food than it would be without them.
As for me, I think I'm going to be using a wedge in the construction of my treehouse by using an axe to chop the wood I need for it. Can you think of any other wedges I might want in my treehouse? Pause the video here to jot down your answers in your guided notes. Now, our final simple machine for today is the screw. Now, if you look closely, closer, like really close, you can actually see that a screw uses an inclined plane. A screw is just a cylinder with an inclined plane wrapped around it in a spiral. Screws can help us with all sorts of things. They can hold objects together, drill holes, or even lift heavy objects. Just like inclined planes and wedges, screws help make work easier by changing the direction of the force applied to them, which pushes objects up that inclined plane spiraled around it. You can find screws used to hold things together almost anywhere you look. Light bulbs, bottle caps, and jar lids all use this simple machine to securely hold their pieces together. Machines like jack screws use a screw to lift extremely heavy loads. Scientists even use screws to pull samples of ice to study from deep within glaciers.
Despite all the amazing ways we use screws, I think I'm just going to stick with the classic for this one. I'm going to use metal screws to hold all the pieces of wood together that I need for my treehouse. Can you think of any other places we use screws? Pause the video here to write down your ideas in your guided notes.
Let's review everything we've learned today about the last three simple machines. An inclined plane, or ramp, is used to move loads between high and low places. It makes work easier by increasing the distance we exert force over. A wedge is two inclined planes put together, and it's used to split things apart more easily. A screw is an inclined plane wrapped around a cylinder, and it helps to hold things together or lift heavy loads. To learn more about inclined planes, wedges, and screws, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions for this lesson. As for me, thanks to the power of simple machines, I now have an amazing new treehouse to study in. I'll see you again soon, but until then, remember, science is all around us. See you next time. Hey.